The glitch effect is a niche one, but also a very cool and useful one when it fits your project style. It can be used as a transition or just randomly within a scene to convey chaos or damage. And the best part is, it's pretty easy to pull off. So today, we're taking a look at how to accomplish this effect inside of Premiere and After Effects. With a clip in our timeline, we're going to create a new adjustment layer, then go to the Effects tab, look up Glitch, and drop in VR Digital Glitch. And we're already halfway there, but we do still need to animate it. So go into Effects Controls and open up the Distortion tab. Now we're going to raise the color distortion to around 75, then to add or remove the amount of glitches in your frame, raise or lower the distortion rate. We're going to set ours to around 60. And to break down any pixels, raise the distortion complexity to your liking. Now we're going to tap the stopwatch next to Distortion Evolution and set some keyframes here. This will give it that extra glitch factor. Once you have a glitch look that you're happy with, go up to Master Amplitude and tap the stopwatch next to that. Move back 3 frames and set your amplitude to 0. With that, you have glitches appearing, but it currently feels unnatural. To fix that, add a transform effect and scale up a bit to give yourself some wiggle room. Now tap the stopwatch next to position and go to your first glitch keyframe and set your starting position keyframe there. Then move a frame forward and change the position just a bit. Move another frame forward and tap this reset parameter icon to set your image to its original position. Repeat this pattern as many times as you would like and feel free to add or remove keyframes to keep it random. You can also try raising the shutter angle to give it a more intense effect or play with the scale keyframe so that your glitch moves in. It all just depends on what you're trying to achieve. And because we added this on top with an adjustment layer, we can hold Alt on Windows or Option on Mac and duplicate this effect multiple times, which works great when cutting something like a promo or music video. You can also take this further by adding on VR chromatic aberration to separate the RGB channels, and wave warp if you want that distorted look. Moving over to After Effects, the first thing that we're going to do is create a new solid, then go to Effect, Noise and Grain, and drop on Fractal Noise. Here, you're going to change the fractal type to max, the noise type to block, bump up the contrast quite a bit, lower your brightness, then inside of the Transform tab, uncheck Uniform Scaling, and while holding down Shift, raise the scale width to something around 5000. Then, while holding Alt on Windows or Option on Mac, you're going to click the stopwatch next to Evolution, which will open this expression box. Type in Time. Time, *1000. Now go to Effects, Transitions, and you have the option to use Radial Wipe or Linear Wipe. You'll see how this affects your clip in just a second. And for this example, we're gonna stick with linear. So now tap the stopwatch next to transition completion and set a start and end keyframe to transition your glitch effect out. Now right-click your solid, pre-compose, move all attributes into the new composition and title it glitch. Next, create a new adjustment layer, go to effects, distort, and drop in a displacement map. Set your displacement map layer to the glitch layer, then keyframe your max horizontal and vertical displacement and set a few random keyframes throughout the glitch. Now right-click all the keyframes and click toggle hold keyframe. Then at the point you want your glitch to end, set your displacement keyframes to 0. And like before, you can keyframe in some chromatic aberration to separate the RGB channels, but now hide your glitch layer and we have our glitch effect. You can, of course, dive in a lot deeper with things like playing with the shift channels effect or offsetting some layers, but that is how you can accomplish a glitch inside of Premiere and After Effects. And if you have a technique that we didn't talk about here, we would love to hear about it. So post that in the comments below. And of course, if there's anything you'd like to see us cover in the future, you can post that down there as well. And don't forget to like and subscribe because hot water can freeze faster than cold water. And you're hot.